My name is James Crowley, and I'm a freelance architectural historian specialising in Catholic places of worship and artefacts. I've been involved in a professional capacity here at the Shrine Church of St Peter and Paul and St Philomena in New Brighton since 2021. It was a great privilege to have been asked to work on this beautiful building, a place of great spirituality and heritage. The Shrine Church is a remarkable building, monumental in scale and hugely ambitious in its construction. It stands as a landmark, both in terms of its prominence on the local skyline and as a testament to the faith of the local Catholic community that built it. The work that has gone into bringing this splendid church back to life in the last decade is one of the finest examples in the country of how communities at historic churches can respond successfully to the challenges that care of such buildings entails. In terms of the history of the church, construction began in 1932 and was completed in August 1935. It replaced an earlier Gothic Revival church of 1881 by the noted Catholic architect Edmund Kirby, which served the Catholic community of New Brighton, which at that time was still a newly established resort town. But by the early 20th century, the first church was too small for its growing community. In 1909, an Irish priest named Father Thomas Mullins was appointed new parish priest here. A man of great vision, Father Mullins established a new building fund soon after his arrival, but it would be the 1930s before construction would begin. It was evident the dream of Father Mullins was to construct a large and prominent church. Having trained in Lisbon, Portugal, he was a great admirer of the city's grand 18th century Estrela Basilica. This became his inspiration for New Brighton. Designs for the new church were presented in 1929, and it was Ernest Bower Norris who was appointed architect to bring to fruition Father Mullins's dream. The Liverpool Post at the time reported on the scheme of the new church and drew comparisons with the design for the Liverpool Metropolitan Cathedral by Edward Lutyens. Norris's firm of Reynolds and Norris designed a number of Catholic churches in the Northwest, including St Dunstan's in Moston and St Willibrord's Clayton, and he's also credited with directing the construction of the wonderful St John's Rochdale, originally designed by Henry Oswald Hill. As with St Peter and Paul and St Philomena, all three of these churches are highly distinctive, with commanding, almost muscular appearance, constructed with innovative use of concrete, with high-quality interior finishes and well-considered decoration. From the outset of construction, there was obvious tension between the vision of the parish priest and the desire of the diocesan authorities, who were in opposition to an overly grand design, rejecting entirely the notion of a dome and suggesting a church with a capacity of 600 would be sufficient. But Father Mullins was a determined man. It is said that on a site visit during construction, Bishop Singleton and his coadjutor, Bishop Moriarty, were surprised to see a grand dome was actually a part of the new building. In response to their inquiries, Father Mullins is said to have replied that he was obliged to build it as such, otherwise he would have had a miserable church. On opening, the scale of the church in its elevated position and with its prominent dome led it to becoming a major landmark on the New Brighton skyline. So much so that in 1939, the church was included in the navigation maps of the Mersey Docks and Harbour Board. It is said that merchant seamen during the Second World War named the church the Dome of Home, as sight of it was confirmation they had returned safely to port. The church became a thriving parish throughout the 20th century, and in 2003 it was listed Grade 2 in recognition of its architectural quality, its innovative construction, its little altered state, and its prominence as a historic local landmark. However, in 2008, the church was closed by the Diocese of Shrewsbury due to substantial and costly building works being required. After his appointment in 2010, the new Bishop of Shrewsbury, Bishop Mark Davies, recognised the importance of the church as one of the most prominent and beautiful in the diocese. He invited the Institute of Christ the King Sovereign Priest to take on responsibility of the church, which was formally reopened as the Shrine Church of St. Peter and Paul and St. Philomena in March 2012. Since 2014, the canons and the worshipping community have overseen major conservation work carried out in four phases, grant aided by numerous sources including the National Lottery Heritage Fund and the National Churches Trust. Although inspired by the fine Baroque Estrela Basilica in Lisbon, the church is only truly Baroque in its layout, with a cruciform plan after the Roman Jesu type. The building is actually classical Renaissance in style. While the church is impressive in scale, it was ingeniously designed to maximise what could be achieved for the budget. The structure is innovatively formed using reinforced concrete for the walling, the dome and the barrel vaulted ceilings, faced with walling of buff brick and concrete dressings rather than carved stone. Internally, the church is impressive in scale. The nave is long and tall and the aisles are arcaded with tall semicircular arches. The dome rises over the crossing with fluted Corinthian pilasters, complete with a whispering gallery. The interior decoration is overall very simple and restrained, serving as a counterpoint to the lavish quality of the major fixtures, principally the classically styled marble high altar and altars in the side chapels, as well as the floors and rails of the sanctuary and side chapels. To give an idea of the importance of the decorative fixtures, the total cost of the original construction was £58,000, but the high altar alone cost £5,000. The altars are each constructed using a variety of different marbles, including Carrara, Cipollino, Siena, Alabaster, and the lady altar has lapis lazuli. There are typical classical details such as columns and pilasters, pediments and mouldings. These are sculpted altars of the highest quality. One notable feature is the fine statue of the Blessed Virgin and Child on the Lady Altar, a late 17th, early 18th century polychrome wood sculpture of Portuguese origin. Other high quality works include the Stations of the Cross sculpted by George Thomas of Liverpool, who is also believed to have carved the relief of the Baptism of Christ located in the baptistry. Recognition of the quality of this handsome church has been gradual, very much the dream of the uncompromising Father Thomas Mullins. His determination provided this grand church, decorated to the highest standards. Were it not for the tireless determination and perhaps a little disobedience of Father Mullins, a church of considerably less quality would likely have resulted, perhaps one that would never have warranted preservation today. And the local community would have been so much the poorer for that. Instead, the Shrine Church of Saints Peter and Paul and St Philomena now stands as an exemplar of Catholic Church restoration projects in the UK. Although conservation work is still ongoing, what has been achieved in the last decade is remarkable. Thanks to the vision of Bishop Davies of Shrewsbury, the dedicated ministry of the canons, and the work and support of the local community, numerous programmes of repairs and improvements, aided by generous contributions from grant givers and donors, has brought this church back to life, which is aiding the spiritual renewal of the region. This church in the heart of its community is once again full of life. Once closed up and in darkness, it is now illuminated, like the city built on a hilltop that cannot be hidden.